Hi, everyone. Aaron here for zollotech, and iOS 14.3 has been out to beta testers or developers and public beta testers a little bit after that. And so I wanted to talk about some features that I didn't cover in my initial video, since quite a few more have been discovered. Now, I have iOS 14.3 beta 1 installed on the iPhone 12 Pro, and my 2020 iPad Pro 12.9 is where I've been using it primarily. And so there's quite a few new features, and the first new feature has to do, well, it's an old feature that they've brought back to older devices. So if you go into your settings, scroll down to camera. Under camera, there's mirror front camera, and I'm getting reports that a lot of people are seeing it on older devices. So if you have an older iPhone, hopefully you're seeing it there. Let me know if you're seeing it or not, but I can't see it on every device since I don't have the beta on all devices, but I'd love to hear from you if you have anything from a 6S all the way up to the 12 Pro Max, of course. So let me hear if you have that in the comments below. Now, another feature is back as well, and that has to do with shortcuts. So if we go into shortcuts, under shortcuts, if we add a shortcut, add an action, and then we search for an action, that's the easiest way, and search for wallpaper, you can now set wallpaper. So this is back. It was removed. It seems like it's back in here now. So you can set the lock screen or home screen wallpaper to an image and have that run as a shortcut. So you could set it to different images and things like that. So that wasn't there before. They brought it back, thankfully. Now there's a new feature, or a new option rather, under settings. So let's go under settings, and then we'll go to Safari. Under Safari, go to search engine, and we now have the option for Ecosia. So I think that's how you say that, but you have Google, Yahoo, Bing, DuckDuckGo, and the new one, Ecosia. I haven't actually heard of them before this update, so you can set your default search engine option to them. So it's a nice little addition if you want to use those. Now, I mentioned a cardio section as far as cardio notifications for the Apple Watch, and if we go to health, let's go under health. Under health, we'll go to browse. And we'll go to heart, and under heart, there should be a new cardio section. So we'll go to cardio fitness, and it talks about cardio fitness, and there's a cardio section as well. So we can just type in cardio and cardio fitness notifications. So it will bring us right back to that. But basically it's talking about learning about cardio fitness, what it means if your cardio fitness is low. And so it's a new section with more information in here that explains all of that. So we should see all of those a little bit later, maybe with the VO2 max being renamed to this. So you'll see here it mentions VO2 max. It's normal for VO2 max to decrease as you get older. So it's going to have all of that information working with your Apple Watch in the future. So it's nice to see them continually update these sections. Now, another thing that was mentioned in the notes, kind of iOS 14.3's notes, is the app clip scanning. Now, it's been discovered that if you go into your app clips or find an app clip, which there isn't really any available, but maybe we'll go into Safari on the iPad, and you'll see this is an iPad, or this is an app clip barcode on the iPad. So if we go into the camera on the iPhone, it will recognize that there's an app clip, and it says no usable data found. So it detected an app clip. It said app clip code detected and no usable data found in a notification. So it sees it as a barcode. If I go back out, go back in again, I can scan that. And again, it sees it. So app clips are coming soon. It's enabled in your camera. Hopefully we'll see that pretty soon. Now, some people have messaged me and said that in this update, they're seeing the activity app on their iPad. Now, I'm not seeing it. I wasn't able to find it. And if I go to the activity app here, let's go to the website for the app. It's not there. So you'll see here's the fitness app or activity, and it's just not there. I tried to find it. I don't see it anywhere on my iPad, but it should be coming soon with the Fitness Plus subscription update. So if I type fitness, you just won't see it. It's not there on my phone, or on my iPad rather. So some people are seeing it. I guess that's a preliminary launch, but I'm not seeing it for myself. Now there's a new option in the camera settings. So if we go into our settings, go down to camera, then go to record video, we now have an option for show pale format. So if you turn this off, they'll disappear from up at the top where you have your video options. Turn on show pale formats and they reappear. And pale is used in other countries outside of the United States. So it says here, pale is a television video format used in many countries in Europe, Africa, Asia, and South America. And basically what that means is 4K 25 or 1080p HD at 25 frames per second. So instead of 24 or 60 that we use in the United States, it's usually 25 or 50. I don't see an option for 4K 50. So they have 4K 25 instead of 24. So it's nice that they've added that as well. Now the TV app has been updated as well. So if we go into the TV app, tap on search, we now have genres. So we have action, comedy, drama, independent, reality, and so on, all of the different genres. So just like the music app, we now have genres for that. So if we go into action, it will show us movies that are related to action. So they've just updated it and made it a little bit easier to view. Now, if you have an iPhone paired to an Apple Watch, such as this iPhone 11 Pro Max, and you go into the Watch app, you'll see for some people, complications is missing. But if I go into it, it says you have no apps with watch face complications installed on your Apple Watch yet. And here are the Apple Watch faces. So I definitely have complications installed. So there's some sort of issue there. So that's something people are seeing. Maybe they're going to update that in the future. Now, as far as other things, well, the Apple Pro RAW support that I showed you earlier in the previous video, you'll see RAW in the upper right for taking photos on the iPhone 12 Pro and 12 Pro Max. The update also appears to add suggested third-party apps. So maybe you're wanting to use RAW. It will apparently eventually suggest apps that can use that RAW file format, whether that be to edit or take better photos. So that should be coming in the future. Now, finally, if we go into settings and then we go down to privacy, under privacy, we'll go to analytics. So we'll go down to analytics and improvements. Under analytics and improvements, there's a new reference to Fitness Plus. So improve Fitness Plus, as you can see here. So it says help Apple improve Fitness Plus by sharing your lorem ipsum. And lorem ipsum is something that's been used for years as sort of a placeholder. So we should see more about that in the future, and you can't turn it on. So it's something that's a little bit new. Now that's it as far as anything new, and the overall experience with it so far, at least on my iPad, has been really smooth. I've had no problems whatsoever. I've had no freezing, no locking up. Of course, I'm not seeing that fitness app that others are seeing, but the overall experience in general has been good. I haven't had any settings freezes. I haven't noticed anything irregular on this iPad. And if I go into settings, go to my battery here. Let me see how much I used it. I charged it to 100% earlier today. So over the past few days, you'll see I used it an hour and 17 minutes the other day. And then I guess that was Thursday. I used it a couple minutes, although I used it for an hour today. So it just depends. I switch back and forth a lot. But in general, after about, I guess, an hour or two of use, I've had no issues. Now, finally, battery life overall on 14.3 beta 1 has been hit or miss, depending on who you ask. Some people say it's not as good. Other people say it's fine. And other people say it's better. So it's going to take more time and more data to figure that out. But right now, I just wanted to update you with some additional features that were found, as well as sort of the overall experience so far. It will take a few more days to see what it's like. And then if you'd like me to do a final follow-up like I do normally, every few weeks or so, let me know in the comments below. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.